Guild of Architects, Professor Mark Anderson. Construction was prefabricated structure.
skin panels. But it has this two-layer skin that is first a kind of dully reflective corrugated galvanized metal skin that's very typical of the rural buildings in that landscape. And then on the outside of that, it wraps a second skin that is this rippling acrylic corrugated skin set off about 2 feet from metal skin. And between these two skins, it sets up both a sort of microclimate of air effects and light effects that make it merge somewhat hazily into the landscape around it. So as a chameleon house, it's intended to be contextual with light of the place that it's within. It draws on some of the materials, some of the construction techniques of the place that it's within. It doesn't mimic the building context, but it still attempts to be very much a part of that place, that view, and that spatial experience. So in a very different way, in California, in another orchard, this is an apple orchard, again, we have the opportunity to take a very special sort of agricultural landscape and place a building within it. It's a series of houses on a farm. And here again, the ambition is to make a building that's quite background to the place and that harnesses the very particular qualities of this agricultural landscape and the geometry of an orchard and place a building within it. So we studied this in a lot of different ways, Excel spreadsheets, prints and drawings, physical models, trying to really understand the space of an orchard. Because an orchard is not a natural landscape in the typical sense. It's a human-constructed landscape. It has a human geometry. And when you're within the geometry of the landscape, it's like being in a building. You're in rows of spaces, and these spaces are defined by solid material similar to walls. They happen to be trees. So in this case, we were trying to build a space of experience within the house that was just a continuation of that same experience of being among the trees. So all of the constructed mass of the building is on the same position of trees, and all of the empty space of the building is following the rows between the trees. So we had to remove some trees, and we replaced those with these solid concrete masses. And then we kept the building below the level of the trees so that it was never asserting itself above the orchard or outside of the orchard. And ultimately, the intention was that the experience of being within this building would be very much analogous to the experience of just having a picnic in a row of trees in the field. So you can see here this view from the kitchen. You're looking down. If you turn left or right, you can see down another row sort of evenly through the orchard. So there's really only four materials in that building: redwood, concrete, painted, plaster, and sheet metal siding. So those four materials become just a background for the orchard, and the space becomes a kind of level datum within that landscape. So another project that we just completed building, and in this case we were the builders as well as the architect. This is an experimental building using CAD-CAM milling of a timber frame and using panelized off-site fabricated components in quite a dense semi-urban residential site. So here, these are examples of the walls and floors of the building that come as large panels that were built in the factory off-site. These are some of the digital models laser cut and fabricated digitally also. So it's not such a different form in terms of its shape or the approach to construction, but its means of construction is quite different in that it's fabricated off-site and run in place. So that allows doing fairly complex timber joinery, the CAD-CAM milling, and relatively custom systems of construction in a quite efficient manner. And so then this house will be very specific to the site, very kind of traditional materials, but it's built very quickly and efficiently in its site. So a lot of the study that we go through has, on the one hand, to do with the means of construction, and the efficiencies, the opportunities that are available in new machinery, new digital methods. But all of that is always set within the context of an overall ambition to make a building that is unique to a site, that focuses on its view opportunities, its relationship to natural light and weather. And it's always this kind of back and forth relationship of the means of construction and the ambition for a kind of rich living within the landscape. These are the finished images of the building, and you can see that there are a lot of all the structure and the joining methods are exposed. That's always an interest of ours to see how we construct the space around us. But that's not usually the driving concept so much as it is the quality of life and light and space within the building. So the building that we have under construction right now in Hawaii is, again, quite a different approach because it's a very different landscape. It's a dry, almost desert-like landscape on a volcanic plateau, and because the weather is so different there, it's very much an indoor-outdoor house. It really has no walls, it only has sliding panels. So you can see that every wall just slides open and closed like the traditional shoji approach. And then it's a large umbrella roof, essentially, a very large shade roof above these sliding doors. So it's a series of identical pavilions, so it's very efficient to construct. Again, it's off-site fabricated steel, and all of these are shipped across the ocean to the island of Hawaii from the mainland of the United States. And we did a lot of study of the framing systems and working on all the efficiencies of the method of construction, because it had to be worked out in quite a bit of detail so that it could be built 2,000, 3,000 miles away from its eventual site of construction. And through the series of models and digital modeling, we then developed all of the steel shop drawings in-house, had the building fabricated and shipped to the site and erected. So you can start to see this landscape is a very wide open landscape with beautiful views to the ocean, to three volcanic peaks, active volcanoes. And the materials here again are only steel, local lava rock, and concrete. So it's a very simple means of construction that's intended to create a very site-specific armature, so that you can live there and be a part of the landscape, part of that climate, in a way that you could not live anywhere else in the world. So even though these are somewhat internationalized building methods, the interest is always to place these within a very local context. So I'm going to go very quickly through this next one. We also are interested build a single-family house with one of the urban scale of multifamily housing. And it's much harder to get these opportunities to do part of the city from the same point of view. But this is a project in New Orleans where we designed a very dense urban housing system where each dwelling unit has four sides open to the natural light and air, so it's almost like individual homes, but set up into a very dense labyrinth of steel structure. Everything's off-site, fabricated, and the intention is to have very indoor-outdoor natural living up higher in the sky, but following a lot of the patterns of urban interaction that are present elsewhere in the city. So again, prefabricated, very efficient building methods, attempting to be a kind of simple background armature for the plants that grow in the sky and for people's lives up in the sky. Lots of components. And as one component of this, we developed a very different sort of infrastructure system that would protect this piece of housing from the river, the flood potential. And rather than having a permanent concrete levee wall that would always block the housing and the natural environment from the edge of the city, as is common in the rest of the landscape, we were intent on trying to find a more natural method of building a resilient levee that could expand and contract as needed. So this works with superabsorbent polymers, and it is a series of parallel bays perpendicular to the flow of the river. And when there is no river flood water present, the superabsorbent dries out and is very contained and thin, so that people can pass back and forth between these massive bladder levees. But when the water rises, it changes to a very swollen form that locks each of these parallel ladders together into a very solid wall that can take the impact of a very strong wave crashing into it and let a little water through, but rather than being catastrophic failure, it's resilient and fills itself back in again. So we think of this as a different way of being specific to the landscape, trying to find other technological ways to adapt to a landscape other than through a sort of massive singular approach to technology. So the very last thing I want to show is a project that we did with students at the University of California, Berkeley. This is a project in which they proposed a community center for competition in Hokkaido, in northern Japan. And it's a project that uses local Japanese types of materials and joinery to build a rural community center that would celebrate the cycles of the seasons in the landscape. So our students won the competition and were then invited to go on to build it. So Kengo Kuma's studio collaborated with us on project, and this is the final result. The students worked for about a year building this, and it has a rammed earth base that rises up partway, has a hearth and a place to be there, and then it comes up into a greenhouse with, again, places to dry fruit and vegetables and fish and a place to eat and to be within the field, but also protected, be in the light, and you feel this kind of massive joinery all around you as you climb up into this this multi-level greenhouse, or you descend back down into the earth of the field and are very much a part of that landscape. So these are the types of interests that we have, Peter and I, in both our our own practice work and to work with our students. The ambition is to work with, and this one is also CAD-CAM fabricated timber, but the intention is always to be very much involved in the means of construction, the techniques, the technologies